Hey guys, welcome to my channel, The Mechanical Engineer. So today we are going to see a pneumatic circuit. The sequence of operation of this circuit is A minus, B plus, B minus, and we are going to delay the motion of A plus. So for this operation, we are going to need two double acting cylinders, that is cylinder A and cylinder B, four sensors, the four walls. These are 3x2 walls which are gonna sense the position of this piston. We are going to delay the motion of A plus, so we are going to need a delay valve and two 4x2 direction control valves to control the direction of this piston inside the cylinder. We are going to need two supply lines. We can use four supply lines, but a system with two supply lines is always the easier. We are going to need a 4x2 direction control valve to control the pressurized air inside these supply lines. So first we are going to start the connection from, this is an FRL unit, that is filter, regulator and a lubricator unit. So as soon as the airflow starts from this compressor over here, we can put a 3x2 direction control valve, that is a push button operated valve, over here. So as soon as the valve starts supplying the pressurized air from here, then this 4x2 direction control valve gets on and it starts to supply the pressurized air in the supply line 2. And then from supply line 2, the first required motion is A minus. So the piston should retract. So first we are going to give the position from here. So that this becomes a pilot for this valve. And we have a compressor over here. And over on these terminals. And then when we want the A minus, that is the retraction of this piston inside the cylinder, this would be how we are going to supply the air inside the cylinder. So as you can see, this unit over here, it is a delay valve. We have a accumulator, which is this one is the accumulator, and here we have a check valve and we have a flow control valve over here. So what happens when the piston starts retracting, the flow of air goes from this check valve over here, this ball opens, it lifts off its seat, and the pressurized air, the compressed air, falls back into the reservoir over here from this line. So here we have achieved the A minus position of this piston over here. So the next motion that we require, it is the B plus. So what we are going to do is the pilot over here. As soon as this, we get this A minus over here, so this sensor over here, it gets actuated from this end of the piston. So the valve over here, this side of the valve, it starts sending the pressurized air, and then the output which we get from that sensor, what we do is we give it to this one as a pilot over here. So as soon as this starts, this 4x2, this side of the valve, is selected by this pilot over here. So from this compressor over here, they start sending compressed air into the cylinder. So now from here, now we have the B positive, that is the B plus motion that we required. So as soon as we get the B plus position, this sensor over here, it is actuated by the end of this piston of cylinder B. So what we'll do is, we will take another supply line from this. And as soon as we get the B plus motion, this starts sending the compressed air on the other side. So we take this line and it becomes a pilot for our group selector, this 4x2 valve. So after we get the B plus position, this sensor over here gets actuated and the supply is switched on from this supply, this line over here, and it becomes a pilot to this wall. So what happened, this side of the wall gets turned on and then the supply passes from here to the supply line 2. Okay, so here the supply of compressed air to line S2 is switched, turned off now, and now the supply is in the line S1. So the next motion we want is B minus. So the piston in the cylinder B should retract. So for that, what we'll do is, from this supply line 1, we take a pilot to this DC wall, and then this side is actuated, this side of the direction control valve is actuated. So what happens, our current, the compressed air, now it flows in this direction. Then the retraction of this piston take place, and as soon as this end of the piston touches this sensor over here, this side of the wall gets actuated. So now as soon as it is actuated, what we'll do is, we will take this pilot line and it will start sending the compressed air on the other side. And then the next motion that we want is the delayed A plus. So this line over here, will go and become a pilot for this wall over here. Then this side of this 4x2 wall will get actuated and it will start passing current over here. So what do we mean by delay? So what is a delay switch? Here we have a flow control valve. So it sends only a control amount of flow, and we can adjust the time of delay using that flow control valve. And we have an accumulator, which is this one. So the flow gets collected into the accumulator, and then once the accumulator is filled with compressed air, so then it starts sending the compressed air from this line, and then we achieve the A plus operation. So then after A plus, this sensor over here gets actuated. So we take another pilot line from here. So after we get the pilot from here, we supply this compressed air to become the pilot for the group selector valve that we have here. Okay guys, now the circuit is complete. Thank you for watching my video and subscribe my channel.